Right, well, a speech by one of New Zealand's Conservative MPs who voted in favour of the laws made global headlines today. Maurice Williamson spoke candidly about those who'd sent him messages opposing same-sex marriage.
The sun will still rise tomorrow. Your teenage daughter will still argue back with you as if she knows everything. Your mortgage will not grow. You will not have skin diseases or rashes or toads in your bed, sir. The world will just carry on. One of the messages I had was that this bill was the cause of our drought. This bill was the cause of our drought. Well, if any of you follow my Twitter account, you will see that in the Pakuranga electorate this morning, it was pouring with rain. We have the most enormous big gay rainbow across my electorate.
Well, the man who made that speech joins us now from Auckland. Thanks very much, Maurice Williamson, for talking to us. I'm sure you didn't do this because you wanted to be a global internet video sensation, but you are now. You must have been inundated over the past 24 hours.
Hamish, it's just been bizarre. I went down to the parliament to take a call and just basically speak on behalf of my electorate, which was a pretty minor thing to do in life. And within minutes of getting back to my office, the phone starts ringing, and next thing my press secretary says, oh, look, Twitter's going wild, and next thing I think YouTube's starting to take hits, and I believe it's over, well over what's considered viral, and the Huffington Post, and Ronan Keating saying, you got to what? And I'm going, I'm sorry, what is all this? I just don't understand.
Did you ever dream of becoming a gay icon?
No, it wasn't one of the things as a young man I'd ever planned on. No, I sort of maybe wanted to, you know, climb mountains or something, or go in and take over a country in politics, but no, that hadn't been one of them.
On a more serious note, though, the points you made, although done in a pretty jovial way, were quite serious and targeted at really respected members of the community. You talked about the clergy. Did you consider that in what you were saying?
There was a few hotheads over here. One Catholic priest said to me I was sanctioning something that was just so unnatural. And I looked at the guy thinking, well, you took an oath of celibacy for the whole of your life and you don't think that's unnatural? And one of the nasty ones came in and said, you'll burn in the fires of hell for eternity. And I would have thought in the year 2013 that no one really believes that that's a genuine thing.
You referred to bullying. Were you surprised at the insidiousness of the attacks on you as an MP your support of this?
No, I've been an MP for a long time. I think it's 28 years now, 27 years. And I've been through this when the homosexual law reform bill went through in the mid-80s. Up until then, homosexuality was illegal and you could go to jail for it. I mean, how bizarre is that? And I had all sorts of threats. You'll lose your seat. You'll never get re-elected. We'll ensure you're a gone burger. You're toast. And by the time of the next election, I got one of the biggest majorities going and have kept that.
If we believe the polls here in Australia, we're likely to get a Conservative government by the end of this year. You're a Conservative MP. Do you think it's easier or more difficult for Conservative MPs to support these sorts of legislation?
Let me give you a cracker example. One of the most conservative blue ribbon National Party seats in this country is called the Wairarapa. It elected a gay, transsexual, I think is the right word, ex-prostitute Maori woman as their MP. So go figure that. That wasn't in some liberal, you know, eastern suburbs of the Auckland city. That was in a rural seat here in New Zealand. So I don't think people vote on these matters, and I think I'm pretty good proof of that, because there will be people in my electorate who are very upset about what I've done. And again, I know you'll have heaps of your viewers tonight saying, this is outrageous, this is dreadful. And all I ask them to think about is, how will it impact on their life? My 90-year-old mother from provincial New Zealand, who's as sort of conservative as they come, she said to me, it's a disgrace that you're supporting this bill. And I said, Mum, tell me how this will impact your life. And she said, well, it's just wrong. I said, no, tell me what it'll do to you. And about 10 minutes later, she said, yeah, well, I suppose if they're a loving couple and they want to be together, yeah, why not? I said, good on you. Good answer.
Maurice Williamson, New Zealand MP and global gay icon. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you lots.
Now, we actually recorded that interview with Maurice Williamson earlier this evening. Off air, we were chatting, and he's been invited on The Ellen Show as well as Letterman, but he said some of the other American press have slightly skewered the story.
Well, one of the papers in New York says, and Morris Williamson, who was openly gay member of parliament, I thought, whoa, I didn't know that. That's news. My wife will be interested to hear that.
They say don't believe everything you read.